Okay.
Ready? One, two, three.
Excuses, excuses, you'll hear them every day. And the devil, he'll supply them if the church you stay away. When people come to know the Lord, the devil always loses. So to keep them folks away from church, he offers them excuses.
In the summer, it's too hot. And in the winter, it's too cold. In the springtime, when the weather's just right, you find someplace else to go. Well, it's up to the mountains or down to the beach or to visit some old friends or to just stay home and kind of relax and hope some of the kinfolk will stop dropping in.
Well, the church benches are too hard and the choir sings way too loud. Boy, you know how nervous you get when you're singing in a great big crowd. The doctor told you, now you better watch them crowds, they'll set you back. But you go to that old ball game because you say it helps you relax.
Well, a headache Sunday morning and a backache Sunday night.
But by work time Monday morning, you're feeling quite all right.
Well, one of the children has a cold.
Pneumonia, do you suppose?
Why, the whole family had to stay home.
Just blow that poor kid's nose.
Excuses, excuses, you'll hear them every day. And the devil, he'll supply them if the church you stay away. When people come to know the Lord, the devil always loses. So to keep them folks away from church, he offers them excuses.
He's too young, and maybe he's too old. The sermons, they're not hard enough, and maybe they're too bold. His voice is much too quiet-like. Sometimes he gets too loud. He needs to have more dignity, or else he's way too proud.
Well, the sermons, they're too long. Maybe they're too short. Well, he ought to preach the word with dignity instead of stomp and snort. Well, that preacher we've got must be the world's most stuck-up man. Well, one of the ladies told me the other day,
didn't even shake my hand.
Excuses, excuses, you'll hear them every day. And the devil, he'll supply them if the church you stay away. When people come to know the Lord, the devil always loses. So to keep them folks away from church, he offers them excuses. So to keep them folks away from church, he offers them excuses.
Every year, for the last 4 years, we've done some kind of scripture memory with the kids. We started with John chapters 1, 2, and 3 last year. This year we're doing John 4 and 5. We do have a cheat for them just in case, because of nerves, and because some of these kids, it's the first time they've learned scripture. We give them 5 or 6, they got 3, and that's the first verses they've ever learned. So we have a little bit of help for him, but they did work to memorize a lot of it. But we gave her all of chapter 4. Yeah.
When therefore the Lord knew how the Pharisees had heard that Jesus made and baptized more disciples than John, but Jesus himself baptized not, but his disciples, he left Judea and departed again into Galilee, and he must needs go through Samaria. Then cometh he to a city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near to the parcel of ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus, therefore, being wearied with his journey, sat thus on the well, and it was about the sixth hour. There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, give me to drink, for his disciples were gone away into the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, how is it that thou, being a Jew, askest drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. The woman saith unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou that living water? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well, and drank thereof himself, and his children, and his cattle? Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water, springing up into everlasting life.
Amen.
The woman saith unto him, Sir, give me this water, that I thirst not, neither come hither to draw. Jesus saith unto her, Go, call thy husband, and come hither. The woman answered and said, I have no husband. Jesus saith unto her, Thou hast well said, I have no husband, for thou hast had five husbands, and he whom thou now hast is not thy husband. And that saidest thou truly. The woman saith unto him, Sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye neither in this mountain nor in Jerusalem shall worship the Father. Ye know not what ye worship. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The woman saith unto him, I know that Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. When he is come, he will tell us all things. Jesus saith unto her, I that speak unto thee am he. And upon this came his disciples, and marveled that he talked with the woman. Yet no man said, What seekest thou, or why talkest thou with her? The woman then left her water pot and went her way into the city, and saith to the men of the city, Come, see man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ? Then they went out of the city and came unto him. In the meanwhile his disciples prayed him, saying, Master, eat. But he said unto them, I have meat to eat that ye know not of. Therefore said the disciples one to another, Hath any man brought him out to eat? Jesus saith unto them, My meat is to do the will of him that sent me, and to finish his work. Say not ye, There are yet 4 months, and then cometh harvest? Behold, I say unto you, lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are white, already to harvest. And he that reapeth receiveth wages, and gathereth fruit until life eternal, that both he that soweth and he that reapeth may rejoice together. And here it is that saying true, one soweth, another reapeth. I sent you to reap that whereupon ye bestowed no labor. Other men labored, and ye are entered into their labors. And many of the Samaritans of that city believed on him for the saying of the woman, which testified, He told me all that ever I did. So when they were come unto him, they besought him that he would tarry with them, and he abode there 2 days, and many more believed because of his own words, and said unto the woman, Now we believe not because of thy word, for we have heard him ourselves, and know that this is indeed the Christ, the Savior of the world. And after 2 days he departed thence, and went to Galilee, for Jesus himself testified that a prophet hath no honor in his own country. Then when he was come into Galilee, the Galileans received him, having seen all the things that he did at Jerusalem at the feast, for they also went into the feast. So Jesus came again into Cana of Galilee, where he made the water wine. And there was a certain nobleman whose son was sick at Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus was come out of Judea into Galilee, he besought him that he would come down and heal his son, for he was at the point of death. Then said Jesus unto him, Except ye see signs and wonders, ye will not believe. The nobleman saith unto him, Sir, come down, and my child die. Jesus saith unto him, Go thy way, thy son liveth. And the man believed the word which Jesus had spoken unto him, and went his way. And as he was now going down, his servants met him in the way and told him, saying, Thy son liveth. Then inquired he of them the hour when he began to amend. And the servants told him, saying, Yesterday, at the seventh hour, the fever left him. So the father knew that it was at the same hour in which Jesus had said unto him, Thy son liveth, and himself believed in his whole house. This is again the second miracle that Jesus did when he was come out of Judea into Galilee.
Cleaning mirrors is something I could really see myself doing.
If a priest blesses an avocado, does that make it holy guacamole?
Who needs commercials for toilet paper? Seriously, who's not buying this stuff?
Ladies, your husband is the perfect person to tell all your secrets to. He's never really listening anyway.
Could you stop making these? I don't like them very much.
I hate to break it to you, but I have another one in the oven.
I don't want to sound insensitive, but have you noticed how much weight you gain when you have these? Well, let's be honest, they never smell good.
Look, let's not argue about this, okay? Why don't we give them to your neighbors? Tell them it's a housewarming gift.
You kidding? Give them that? They're going to think we're nuts or something.
Nonsense, they'll love it. Do you think I should give them in person, or just leave it on their doorstep?
Just leave it on their doorstep. I don't want them to know we gave it to them. They might try to give it back. Great. Now it's dripping all over me. Honestly, these things are such a nice pair of holders.
You could have stained the carpet. I don't understand this aversion you have.
I just have no use for them, except for maybe as a paperweight, then it gets nastiness everywhere.
That's it. I'm going to my mother's.
Good. Take this with you. She hasn't had one in years. She'll probably love it.
I'm leaving that with you until you learn to appreciate it.
This is why I wanted a dog.
Now, as many of you may have realized, that wasn't quite as funny. You see, we here at Bible Baptist spend many hours writing, revising, and completely rewriting our shows. Sometimes they don't have to be written, but merely looked in a different way. Now look what happens when we switch this delicious pastry with a baby.
I don't want to keep bringing this up, but could you stop making these? I don't like
it. I hate to bring it to you, but I have another one in the oven.
I know this sounds excessive, but have you noticed how much weight you gain when you have these?
Look, let's not argue about this, okay? Why don't we give it to the neighbors? Tell them it's a housewarming gift.
Give them that, and they're going to think we're crazy.
Nonsense, they'll love it. Do you think I should give it to them in person, or just leave it on their doorstep?
Just leave it on their doorstep. I want them to know we gave it to them. They might try to give it back. Great, now it's dripping all over me. Honestly, these things are such a nice holders.
You could have stained the carpet. I don't understand this aversion you have.
I just have no use for them, except for maybe as a paperweight, but then again, it's nastiness everywhere.
That's it! I'm going to my mother's.
Good, take this with you. She hasn't had one in years. She'll love it.
I'm leaving that with you until you learn to appreciate it.
This is why I wanted a dog.
Now, in an effort to make it so that some of these kids understand why these things are funny, and to reach the new generation, these are actual tweets sent out by real-life husbands that we're going to recite for you now, with props. These are things that husbands have actually said. Whether or not they survived saying it, we don't know.
I don't understand how God can have 10 commandments for the whole world, but my wife can have 152 for just our house.
My wife said I was childish. I was speechless. It's hard to say anything when you have a mouthful of gummy bears.
After waking up from a car crash in a full body cast, my wife was right at my bedside to tell me that childbirth was still more painful.
Whenever my wife falls asleep in a public place, I always shake her in a little and yell, "Don't you die on me!" People always clap when she wakes up.
Before I was married, I didn't even know there was a wrong way to put the milk back in the fridge.
So, my wife asked me what I wanted for dinner, and then she told me it was wrong.
Never ask a woman who is eating ice cream straight from the carton
how she's doing.
My wife probably tells me I never listen to her.
I wear a clown mask to sleep just in case one of my kids has a nightmare and comes to sleep in our bed.
Send
send me? How shall I send me? I'm going to send me 4x4, 4x4 that stood at the door, 3 by the Hebrew children, 2 by Paul and Silas, 1 by the little bitty baby who was born in Bethlehem. Children, know where I send me? How shall I send me? I'm going to send me 5x5, 5x5 that couldn't get by, 4x4 that stood at the door, 3 by the Hebrew children, 2 by Paul and Silas, 1 by the little bitty baby who was born in Bethlehem. Yes, he was born in Bethlehem.
My grade, so I put him up for adoption.
Oh, that's good. I like that.
There's a fine line between the numerator and the denominator. Only a fraction of people will get it.
Hey, Israel, you jumped the gun, dude. You got a one-liner now. Come out the wall. Boy, listen.
You
got to
do this
first. He's new.
I'm going to go stand outside, so if anyone's asking, I'm outstanding.
If you ever get cold, stand in a corner. They're usually about 90 degrees.
To address the fact that you are obese.
Well, you see, the thing is, obesity runs in my family.
No, the problem is no one runs in your family.
Samantha, do you have a newspaper I can borrow?
Dad, this is the 21st century. Nobody reads a newspaper anymore. Here, use my iPad.
Okay, but that fly ain't gonna know what hit him.
No!
Gummy bears, anyone? Hey, guys. I wanted to address that this new guy at work I invited. He seems really shy. I think it's the first party he's ever been to, so I can make him feel like part of the group.
Maybe we can play a group game or something.
There you go.
Maybe apples to apples.
No! I hate apples to apples! No one ever picks my cards!
Jeez, Big Better cards, what's so hard about that?
How about Mafia?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Yeah, that's perfect. Oh, that's gotta be him. Hey everyone, this is Jason.
What?
Hey, Gummy, we're just about to play Mafia.
Yeah, come see my pen.
What's Mafia?
Oh, you'll love it.
Yeah, I'm just going to get some cards, then I'll explain the rules. Okay. Whoever gets Jack is Mafia, so don't let anyone see your card, okay? Don't show it to anyone.
Oh, I love being Mafia. You can kill people.
Kill people?
Yeah, you'll love it.
Okay. Everyone, close your eyes. Mafia, stand up and choose someone to kill. I want to make sure that they know you killed them, and try to be quiet so no one knows who it is. Okay, Mafia, I'm going to count down 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, everyone open your eyes.
Wow, it actually looks dead. They did a crime scene and everything. He doesn't even have a pulse. That's intense.
Okay, guys, this is where we need to try to accuse each other, try to find out who did it.
I think it's Winnie. She's always had it out for Steven.
The first person to call it is always Mafia.
I think it was Jenna. I heard some rustling over in our area.
I
think it's Jeremy. He always gets like lazy eyes blind.
Oh, come on, I have astigmatism. You with your perfect 20/20 vision. Besides, I think Jason did.
No! You can't prove anything!
Read that 4,153,237 people got married last year. Not to cause any problems, but shouldn't that be an even number?
Ever feel like your job is pointless? Remember, there was a lifeguard poolside at the Olympics last summer.
Oh, that's smart.
John 5. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went down into Jerusalem. Now there is at Jerusalem, by the sheep market, a pool, which in the Hebrew tongue is called Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water. For in a certain season, an angel came down and stepped into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in, was made whole of whatsoever diseases he had. Now there was a certain man there who had an infirmity 38 years. And when Jesus saw him lie, and knew that he had been now long in that case, he saith unto him, Look up, be made whole.
The impotent man answered him, Sir, I have no man. When the water is troubled, to put me into the pool, but while I am coming, another step is down before me. Jesus saith unto him, Rise, take up thy bed, and walk. And immediately the man was made whole, and took up his bed, and walked. And on the same day was the Sabbath. The Jews therefore said unto him that was cured, It is the Sabbath. It is not lawful for you to carry thy bed. Then asked they him, What man is that which said unto thee, Take up thy bed and walk?
And he that was healed wist not who it was, for Jesus had conveyed himself away, a multitude being in that place. After Jesus findeth him in the temple and said unto him, Behold, thou art made whole. Sin no more, lest a worse thing come unto thee. The man departed and told the Jews that it was Jesus which had made him whole. And therefore did the Jews persecute Jesus and sought to slay him, because he had done these things on the Sabbath day. But Jesus answered them, My Father worketh here hitherto, and I work. Therefore the Jews sought the more to kill him, because he had not only broken the Sabbath, but said also that God was his Father, making himself equal with God.
Then answered Jesus and said to him, Verily, verily, I say unto you, the Son can do nothing of himself what is seeth the Father do. For what things soever he doeth, these also doeth the Son likewise. For the Father loveth the Son, and showeth him all things that himself doeth, that he may show him greater works than these, that ye may marvel. For the Father raiseth up the dead, and quickeneth them, even so the Son quickeneth whom he will. For the Father judgeth no man, but hath committed all judgment unto the Son. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word, and believeth on him that sent me, hath everlasting life, and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death to life.
The rotation of the earth really makes my day.
Why don't psychics win the lottery?
That's my cue.
No, you always get to put in your 2 cents worth, but it's a penny for your thoughts. Where's the other penny go?
What mouse walks on 2 legs?
I don't know.
Mickey Mouse. What duck walks on 2 legs?
Donald Duck.
All ducks stupid.
I hate you!
Nice knowing you, Jordan.
Now, last year, we did a tongue twister with Caleb and Sam from The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. And it went over really, really well. Called Copper Clappers. This year we decided, why don't we expand it and do something bigger? So we're going to do Dana's Dead. But we're going to involve more than just a couple. And because there are more people involved, there's more chances for them to mess this up. But if this one messes up, it's actually pretty funny. So we're going to give them five chances. If after the fifth chance, after the fifth attempt, we'll just let her go from there, let them correct themselves, and they won't have to reset and start over. But if they mess up the first five times, they have to go back to the beginning. Yeah.
Guys, can we go get Dana?
What happened?
She's dead.
Dana's dead?
At the door now.
What'd she do?
She was diving into a deep ditch and did a double flip.
Dana, deep ditch diving? Wasn't Dana digging Dylan's card?
No.
That's one.
Guys, come quick. It's Dana.
What happened?
She's dead.
Dana's dead.
What's she doing?
She was diving into a deep dish and did a double flip.
Dana deep dish diving? Wasn't Dana digging Doug's garden?
No, Dylan digs Doug's garden. Dana digs Drake's garden.
Yes, but then she went deep dish diving. I didn't deep dish, but I didn't see Dana. Dudes, don't despair. Dana didn't dive deep dish diving. She died trying to draw Drowsy Ducks while down by Dairy Queen while dining Dilly Bar in South Dakota.
Dana drawing Drowsy Ducks? Did she do drugs?
I doubt it was Dana.
Guys, come quick. It's Dana.
What happened?
She's dead. That's a door now. She was diving into a deep dish and just double flip.
Dana deep dish diving? Wasn't Dana digging Doug's garden?
No, Dylan digs Doug's garden. Dana digs Drake's garden.
Yes, but then she went deep dish diving. I dreamed the deep dish but didn't see Dana. Dudes, don't despair. Dana didn't dive deep dish diving. She died trying to draw Jazzy Ducks down by Dairy Queen Dolly and Dilly Bar in South Dakota.
Dana drawing Jazzy Ducks? Did she do drugs?
I doubt it was Dana. She doesn't do well downing dairy or drawing Jazzy Ducks.
Don't you dare doubt me like that.
They got it!
Dana!
Dana!
Oh, Dana, after you did drugs and deep dish drove by drawing deep dish, and you decided you died deep dish driving by Dodge Dakota and a Dilly Bar driving by DQ, did I seriously doubt it? Because don't you just like downing dairy and drawing Jazzy Ducks?
Yeah!
Verily, verily, like John chapter 5, verse 25 through 30. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is, when the dead shall hear the voice of Son of God, and they that hear shall live. For as the Father hath life in himself, so hath he given to the Son to him have life in himself, and hath given him authority to execute judgment also, because he is the Son of Man. Marvel not at this, for the hour is coming, in which all that are in the graves shall hear his voice, and shall come forth, they that have done good, unto the resurrection of his life, and they that have done evil unto the resurrection of damnation. I can of mine own self do nothing as I hear. I judge, and my judge of my judgment is just, because I seek not mine own will, but the will of the Father which has sent me.
John chapter 5, verses 31-36. If I bear witness of myself, my witness is not true. There is another that bear witness unto me, and I know that the witness that he witnesseth of me is true. Ye say unto John, and he bear witness unto the truth. But these things I say... Wait. But I receive not testimony from man,
But these things I say that ye might be saved. He was burning and a shining light, and ye were willing for a season to rejoice in his light. But I have a greater witness than that of John, for the works which the Father hath given me to finish, the same works that I do, bear witness of me that the Father hath sent me.
John chapter 5, verses 37 through 41. And the Father himself which hath sent me hath borne witness of me. Ye have neither heard this voice at any time, nor seen his shape. And ye have not his word abiding in you, for whom he hath sent me, whom he hath sent, him ye believe not. Search the scriptures, for in them ye think ye have eternal life, and that they are they which testify of me. And ye will not come to me, that ye might have life. I receive not honor from them.
John chapter 5, verses 42 through 47. But I know you, that ye have not the love of God in you. I have come in my Father's name, and ye shall not receive. Another shall come in his own name, and ye will receive. How can ye believe which receive honor one of another, and seek not the honor that cometh from God only? Do not think that I will accuse you to the Father. There is one that accuseth you, even Moses, in whom ye trust. For had ye believed Moses, ye would have believed me, for he wrote you. But if ye believe not his writings, how shall ye believe my words?
One song I got music for.
We don't hold up. We have some lessons.
It's okay.
Nothing. There we go.
Years from now.
I think you mean aerobic.
Oh, yes. There's choking hazards, survival shows,
and Grandpa's infamous chicken neck surprise.
Invaders from Mars and hunting wound scars and jello mold shaped like one-legged kangaroos. Who wrote that?
I wrote it myself.
Well, moving on then. There's bad hair days and high school plays and recipes that use tofu.
There's the IRS, the CIA, AOL, and R2-D2. The PTA, the FBI, and also OPU.
OPU? OPU!
And wormholes and computer viruses, medication side effects, broken limbs and psoriasis.
Commercials and junk mail and political debates, market drops and fallen crops, and soaring interest rates.
The taxes, crime, or death, they cannot harm us anyhow. Cause we'll all be green and moldy 100 years from now. 100 years from now.
This concludes the entertainment of our evening. We want to thank you very much for your support tonight, for coming out and helping these kids earn their way to camp. You've heard an awful lot of scripture tonight. You've heard some goofy songs. You've heard some really good songs, some God-honoring songs, including the last one. Almost. If you don't know for sure that you're going to heaven when you die, you're in the right place. We can take time tonight, take 5 minutes, and show you from the Bible so you know for sure how you're going to heaven above and not that other place below.
That's right.
And we would love to take time today. You can ask me, my wife, the pastor, whoever's here with you. They would love to talk to you and get that settled for you right now. Again, thank you very much tonight. My name is Jason Haney. I'm the youth pastor here. This is my lovely wife, Nicole. She's the one who keeps everything organized. She's the cat herder. She's the one who keeps this all organized, and this is not possible without her doing an awful lot of work to make me look good. And the rest of our merry band of misfits are...
Well, I'm Brenda.
Jordan Bedoya.
Isaiah Lopez.
Samantha Marisay.
Catherine Mayan.
Liana Cuera.
Joshua Mahaney.
Hudson Marisay.
Julie Goldsboro.
Kevin Bowen.
Donovan Bowen.
Israel Lopez.
Thank you very much. If you don't have some place to go to church tomorrow, come visit us. Service starts at 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock. God bless you.
Thank you.